All right, here we go with round one. And sometimes when you have a closely contested matchup on paper, grapple versus grapple, you see a striking efficiency. All indications are these guys are going to try to try and do what they want.
They will try to put, right? They may try and strike. They are grapplers at their core. At their core, they need to be in contact. The only issue is normally for both of these guys, when they're in these grappling exchanges, they never face anyone that says the worst or as good in these positions as they are tonight. They get mirror images of themselves.
All right, so you gotta be careful playing on the ground with this guy. You don't want to mess around for too long. All right, working inside the crow's guard now. Bottom fighter here, maybe looking to hip escape, DC.
Oh! He did a great job of reversing the position, using the opening that his opponent gave him to shut him off and get back up.
Just missed with the left hook. Here is the punches by him there. He has been busy throughout.
He's doing a great job with the hands. He looks like a professional boxer out there.
Oh, stuffs the takedown without issues. And they separate.
Much improved defensively as he blocks the shot.
Oh, and he caught the kick. For the heavyweight Curtis Blaydes. All right, both fighters now can again go down. That will absolutely work.
It will absolutely work because every time he shoots, he is being observed. He is going to secure a takedown.
I love watching this guy move on the ground. Another nice transition there.
Such a high-level grappler. You don't see that very often.
Bottom fighter trying to control posture, unable to do so.
Now, he's in a lot of danger. He's got to grab that head, or he's going to get back.
Outstanding round and count here. Somewhat of a lost art in MMA, at least in terms of making sure that every strike counts. Not an issue for him.
He's making every single one of them count. He's not doing that. He's not touching. Every punch that lands, he wants you to feel it.
Two, round one, pretty good, not great, but some action on both sides.
We can't always hold the power up, Sean. Yeah. Sometimes you gotta deal with the ebbs and flows of a fight. In round number one, you have success. Let's see if he really charges out ahead in the second round.
All right, he closes the distance, gets the single ball. Keeps going back to that jab, keeps throwing that jab, but I'm going to
a big ball was playing.
More fun to watch in mixed martial arts than these type of transitions and scrambles on the ground.
High-level grappling can really be entertaining.
Well, you see all the grappling repetitions here. Just beautiful movement, seamless transitions on the ground.
Over and over, these guys are doing things that you see in every jiu-jitsu gym around the country.
All right, looks like he's got a couple hooks in here, DC, and defensively, you better be careful. Beautiful movement, hip work on the ground here, just outstanding with the transition.
He is not staying in one place on the ground, and that's very important.
Well, you know, I don't like the gi very much, but I have an appreciation and a healthy one for these type of transitions.
You can tell he's been in the gi at some point, but the way that he moves, so freely.
I'm skipping jiu-jitsu next week, too. All right, so he postures up here and now figures to rain down some ground strikes.
Yeah, the ground and pound will be a play from this position.
Oh, he's got the ground and pound going now. Thursday, he needed to be more effective in these situations. Certainly effective tonight.
Many people have gone away from this style of fighting. This man has embraced it, and you are seeing why. He's one of the best that we've seen do it in a long time.
All right, he's hanging out inside the closed guard of his opponent here, DC. You gotta be careful. All right, another round is now underway. Pretty good previous two rounds. We'll see who makes the requisite adjustments.
The adjustments are going to be the key, John. If it stays this close, you got to really switch it up. The corner is able to relay that message.
Let's see if he can capitalize and lock up a sub.
You got to try to find whether or not you're going to land. Round and pound here.
He's trying to control posture here. Now trying to hip escape.
He's just trying to move out of this position off the bottom.
Posturing up now.
And now the damage is about to start.
But you got to be very careful hanging out here for too long if you're his opponent. Blades is right back to the full mount here. Just over 2 minutes to go in our third and final round.
Yeah, you got to watch one of the best strikers in the entire UFC. He did everything so well, and in my opinion, he should cruise to a very easy decision.
The official decision is in. Here's Bruce Buffer.
Ladies and gentlemen, after three rounds, we go to the judges' scorecards for a decision. The judges score the contest
30-26, 29-27, and 30-26.
For the winner by unanimous decision, Curtis Mayfield!
All right, congratulations to him. He is your winner by unanimous decision and certainly a dominant performance.
Yeah, he did a great job of just dictating control. All the engagements of this fight.
No rush, really slow touch, Brian away. I go punch, grab a spot, they can go bust, eye for eye, they can lose trust. White rum, fizzy pop, where you they go, go, with they go up. Catch my vibe, let me go off, slam the trash, man it's so tough.
Alright yo, put the belly on her body, make a clutch. See no watch, now she wanna give. Boy got peas, now she hopping in the pod. Man a real life, sugar gal, I might forget what. When she want dark, told her meet me at the top. Switching lanes the other day, I seen her waiting for a bus. Minutes a month, clear sweater, diesel denim. Buy another one, my pockets fight like heather. Neck froze like I don't know no better. Benzo truck, white seats and they leather. Go broke, never.